My dear students, Assalamu alaikum. I hope you are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. We were talking about the fat-soluble vitamin. Today we shall talk about the vitamin D. As you know that the vitamin D consists of a group of sterols with hormone-like functions. So, in respect to vitamin D, the initial talk is this, that the vitamin D consists of a group of sterols with the function of like hormone. Active form of vitamin D is 1,25-dihydroxycholecalciferol, also known as calcitriol. They exist in nature in two forms. Number one is argocalciferol, that is the vitamin B2, which is derived from plant source. Secondly, cholecalciferol, that is the vitamin D3, it is derived from animal source. The first one, vitamin D, argocalciferol, it is derived from plant source, as I have already mentioned, is poorly absorbed. So, nutritionally it is not important, but vitamin D3 is important nutritionally. Now come to sources of vitamin D. Dietary source, that is the exogenous source, oily fishes, fish liver oil, egg yolk, liver, milk and milk products are quite good sources of vitamin D. But the main source is the endogenous source. It can meet about 80-90% of body need. 7-dehydrocholesterol, the precursor of cholecalciferol, are synthesized in liver from cholesterol and stored in epidermis of skin. In single word, 7-dehydrocholesterol present in epidermis of skin. But the thing is this, if you want to know that the main thing is the cholesterol. From the cholesterol, liver produces cholecalciferol, and this cholecalciferol is the precursor of 7-dehydrocholesterol, and this 7-dehydrocholesterol is stored or present in the epidermis of skin. That is, in short, 7-dehydrocholesterol is present in the epidermis of skin, which is on exposure to ultraviolet ray of sunlight, 7-dehydrocholesterol is converted to cholecalciferol. That is, the 7-dehydrocholesterol stored in the epidermis of skin undergoes exposure to ultraviolet ray of sunlight and is converted to cholecalciferol. Now comes the in respect to metabolism, how it is absorbed. Dietary vitamin D3, that is the cholecalciferol, is absorbed from intestine along with fat with the help of bile salts and the mycelium. After absorption, within enterocyte, it is packaged into chylomicron and carried by chylomicron to systemic circulation, where it is transported bound to a specific globulin called vitamin D binding protein. Next is the vitamin D3 produced in skin by ultraviolet light is readily absorbed and transported in blood bound to vitamin D binding protein. So, the dietary sources undergoes the digestion and then absorption, and it goes to the chylomicron. Through this chylomicron it goes to systemic blood circulation, where it binds with the vitamin D binding protein. And in respect to vitamin D3, which is synthesized under the epidermis of the skin by the ultraviolet light, is absorbed and transported in blood and bound to vitamin D binding proteins. Now come to photogenesis of calcitriol, or the main vitamin which is our target of learning. From exogenous and endogenous sources, vitamin D3 is absorbed to blood. From blood it goes to the liver and hydroxylated at 25th position to form 25-hydroxycholecalciferol by 25-hydroxylase enzyme. So you have to understand this one, that the when it is absorbed in the blood, it goes to the liver. And in liver it is hydroxylated by the enzyme 25-hydroxylase, and it forms the 25-hydroxycholecalciferol. That is, the enzyme is the 25-hydroxylase, and it acts on the vitamin D3 that is the absorbed in the liver, there it undergoes hydroxylation and it forms the 25-hydroxycholecalciferol. Secondly, 25-hydroxycholecalciferol then goes to kidney. The previous one was in liver, now in kidney, and undergoes again hydroxylation in first position to produce 1,25-dihydroxycholecalciferol. That is the calcitriol. That is the calcitriol, the active form, by 1-alpha-hydroxylase present in renal tubular cell. So there is 2 hydroxylation. One is in the liver, another is in the kidney. The first one is by 25-hydroxylase enzyme, and the second one is the 1-alpha-hydrolase enzyme. And first one occurs in the liver, second one occurs in the kidney. First one 25-hydroxylase, after the hydroxylation it produces in 25th position, that's why its name is 25-hydroxycholecalciferol. This goes to the kidney, and there next hydroxylation occurs, and there it names it, it is hydroxylated at first position. That's why it is termed as 1,25-dihydroxycholecalciferol, which is the active form, and the other name is calcitriol. Now comes to regulation. The concentration of 1,25-dihydroxycholecalciferol is regulated by plasma levels of calcium and phosphate. They control hydroxylation reaction position. 1, low plasma phosphate increases the activity of 25-hydroxycholecalciferol, 1-hydroxylase. Low plasma calcium enhances the production of parathyroid hormone, which in turn activates the 1-hydroxylase. Thus, the action of phosphate is direct, while that of calcium is indirect on kidney 1-hydroxylase. Thus, the main thing is this, that the regulation of calcitriol is maintained by the parathyroid hormone, by the hypophosphatemia, and hypocalcemia. So it is to be in mentioned that there is negative feedback mechanism. There is negative feedback mechanism. Now comes the mechanism of action of calcitriol. Like steroid hormone, it acts by gene activation. In a single word, if we mention, then we can say that like steroid hormone acts by gene activation. Vitamin D binds with specific receptor present in the nucleus of target tissues. The activated vitamin D receptor complex binds to DNA and activates a specific gene to make messenger RNA by transcription. Finally, messenger RNA comes out to cytoplasm and here by translation produces a specific protein which mediates several physiological functions in cells. So this is the way how the calcitriol acts. Requirement of vitamin D. On an average 600 international unit per day, that is the 15 microgram per day we require for the adult person of age 1 to 70 and on an average, that's why this is 600 international unit per day or 15 microgram per day. Function of vitamin D. The overall function of calcitriol is maintain adequate serum levels of calcium. It performs this by acting on three target tissues, that is the intestine, kidney and bone. Intestine, it acts on intestinal mucosa to increase calcium and phosphate absorption. In kidney, it helps in calcium reabsorption from kidney and thus reduces the excretion of calcium in urine. In bone, when blood calcium is low, it stimulates bone to increase calcium resorption. The result is increase in serum calcium. In the osteoblast of bone, it deposits calcium phosphate and thus helps in mineralization of bone. In regards to deficiency disorders of vitamin D, the deficiency diseases are rickets in children, osteomalacia in adults. Features of rickets. Due to insufficient mineralization of bone, there is deformities of bone. These are bow legs, knock knees, bulging of the frontal bones, rickety rosary, pigeon chest, etc. Osteomalacia. The bones become soft due to insufficient mineralization. Patients are more prone to fractures. This is common in women who seldom goes outside and get less exposure to sunlight. Renal rickets. In kidney disease, even if vitamin D is available, calcitriol is not synthesized. So in chronic kidney disease, rickets occur, which is known as renal rickets. Now, justify vitamin D as a hormone. Like hormone is endogenously synthesized in skin and then enters the blood. Through blood it enters the target tissues and acts there. The target tissues, as I have mentioned, is the intestine, kidney and bone. Like hormone, the synthesized of vitamin D is self-regulated. That is why The initial term we have mentioned that it is the function of vitamin D is like hormone. So these are all about vitamin D in short. In the next class we will discuss about the vitamin K and vitamin E, and the revision class will be all about the vitamins, both soluble and the fat soluble vitamins. Thank you all.